What is up, folks? What is up, folks? We are live. We are live with a very special guest. We have Larry Frost. We are expecting Von Helton. Well, we'll see if he shows up or if he's the coward of Clay County. I'm going to unmute Larry here. We were having some headset problems, so we're going to make sure that everything's working here. We might get a little echo, but how you doing?
Hey, I'm doing really good.
All right, on. Everyone can hear us out there. They'll let us know. So we're just waiting on Von Helton.
Me and my wife sitting here making a dollar bet that he don't show up. He won't get on.
He claims to be the Punisher. He claims to be the man.
He's a boy. My 14-year-old's more of a man than he is.
Now, just so people have some context, Larry, how are you related? Like, how do you know Von Helton?
Do I have to really say? Just say I'm related.
Okay.
His mother is my great aunt. So his mother and my grandfather is brother and sister.
And you're saying that your grandfather wouldn't be too happy at what he's seeing right now.
My grandfather would roll over in his grave if he knew somebody was treating his sister that way, his baby sister.
Wow. So you've been looking after Alice lately?
Well, I did for a while, and then he said that he had a 2-year degree in college and that he could take care of it all. So we let him do it for 3 months, and she is $1,000 on AARP. And her phone bill went up to $700.
Wow.
The only thing he paid was the water and electricity. He won't take her to a doctor's. I got to take her to the doctor's. He won't get her medicine for her. I pay for the medicine.
Mm-hmm.
Won't take now, her to the grocery store. He makes her. Go ahead.
Oh, go ahead. No, you go ahead.
He don't take her to the grocery store. He just buys off the Swanson truck.
Right. Yeah, we saw that. Now, I just want to put out there, you had said that Andrea was interested, and I see an account out there, Andrea Locke. Is that her watching?
That's her. She is.
Wow. Andrea, I would like to say hello, and I am so glad that things are going better for you these days, apparently, as far as I know.
Yeah, she's been doing good once she's on her meds.
Yeah, and out of that trailer.
Well, I think it all had to do with him not letting her go to the doctors, and he wouldn't let her take her medicines.
That'd
drive anybody crazy.
Oh, yeah.
You take my wife off her medicine, and buddy, I'm dead meat within 48 hours. And she'll be in the hospital.
Wow. Wow. And you were saying there was another cousin that had a few things to say.
Yeah, they're on here too. Joe and them said they're on there. Joe and Jennifer.
Well, if Joe and Jennifer ever want to come on, they're free too as well. So
they're watching.
Yeah. So Von Helton, I know you're watching too. I know for a fact Von Helton is watching this tonight. He has been sent the link, folks. There's no excuse for him not to come in. Other than that, he's a coward and doesn't want to be a man, face Larry.
He's definitely a coward.
Now, Von Helton, that's kind of weird because he claims to be Mr. Special Ops. He's trying to tell people he's over 6 foot tall.
He ain't but 5'10".
Is he even that tall?
Yeah, he's about 5'10", maybe 5'8", 5'10", somewhere in there.
Okay.
About 150 pounds.
I'd give him a little heavier. He looks a little plumper these days.
Well, yeah, he's eating all his mom's food.
Now, that's an interesting point, Larry, because he's been making a lot of accusations that it's the family that's been stealing out of the freezer.
We're the ones taking her the food.
That makes more sense.
I personally have never, ever took any food out of her home.
No, I hear you.
But I guarantee you I've put more than $500 in her house.
Yep, I hear you. Now listen, Larry, what I'm going to do I'm just going to put it on mute for a quick second because I have a little video clip that Von Helton put up a couple weeks back where he's talking some shit. So it's real short. I'm just going to mute you and let you listen to it for a sec, then you can respond.
Okay.
Von Helton, you have a chance to come in here and defend yourself. You know you do. And I know you're watching. So we're just going to check this out for a sec.
All right, I am documenting the fact that I have spent almost $600 in food, and it is in her freezer. Her freezer is now filled almost completely full. $600, almost $600 worth of food. $580-some worth of food. Almost $600 worth of food. So if they come and say that she's starving to death and that she ain't got no food, well, then it's because they ate it all, because here it is, and you all can see it. Yeah, right, Mom? And I bought it just now from the Schwann's man, so, and it's all brand new, so they can't say it's old food.
And they're not. Nobody else going to eat it.
Well, see, that's what they're doing. They're coming in, eating your food, and then they're saying that you ain't got no food.
Well, I'll see you to it.
That's what they're doing. That has to be what they're doing, because I've stocked this twice now. And as you can see, it's completely stocked full of food. And then they'll come and they'll eat it all. And then they'll say, well, she ain't got no food.
I never seen nobody get nothing out of there.
Honey, they do. Trust me, they do. Either that or they're coming in and stealing it from you, one or the other. Either way, they have said many times that you ain't got nothing.
Well,
so that's why I'm documenting it this time, so that they can't do that.
But that ain't right.
Well, I know it ain't, but that's what they're doing. All right, anyway, that's going to do it.
All right, Larry. Well, that's what he's got to say.
Well, yeah, she does have food now. I know that. But, you know, that's her money. And the only one stealing her food is him.
Yeah.
He goes over there every day and takes food out of her house.
Of course he does. Where would he get $600 to buy Schwann's? He doesn't have any money.
From his mom's bank account?
Exactly. Now, speaking of that quickly, you had mentioned that there's a significant amount of money missing from Ma's bank account.
Yeah, about $25,000.
Wow.
And he says it wasn't there, but when he took over the bills and he took over the checkbook, it was all there.
So he's siphoned that money out over time.
No, he literally closed the whole bank account.
Wow.
And put it in his name, put it under him. Saying he's power of attorney and he's taking it all. It's his inheritance.
Yeah, he thinks he's entitled to that money.
Yeah, well, same reason he thinks he's entitled to have free rent.
Because
it's his mom's. Well, it ain't his until his mommy's gone.
Yep.
Yeah. And I've seen the what do they call that? A will? He gets nothing. $200 a month for the rest of his life.
Yeah. Well, that's how it goes when you spend all the money. Because it's funny, because he's been making videos flashing big wads of money, $3,000 at a time. I mean, Hot Wheels.
That's because he took all his mom's money out of the safety deposit box.
That's outrageous.
It's just like all them guns he's been showing on here.
Yeah.
Them are all his mom's guns. None of them belong to him.
That's what we kind of thought. We knew she had possession because he wasn't allowed to have them for a little while.
No, he still got them. He won't give them back to her. Yep, he still got them.
That's wild. So
somebody told me the.
Go ahead.
No, you go. I say somebody told me the other day I better watch him because he's got a gun, You know what I did? I called the next door neighbor and told him to come on down here and see me for a minute. He goes, what's wrong? I was like, I'll make sure Irby don't pull a gun on me because he ain't got a CCW. Mm-hmm. And the next door neighbor has a CCW.
Right.
Irby comes out of that house with that gun in his hand, he goes to jail.
That's right. And you had mentioned that another cousin had come down to visit and he chased her off the property with the gun.
Yeah, yeah. Jessica came down to see him or see Alice and he chased her off the property with the gun.
And when was that?
Last year. And I told her yesterday. I told her yesterday, if she wants to come down and see Alice, come on down here and call me before she gets there. And I will go over there with her. Mm-hmm. When I go over there, he runs in his house and won't come back out.
Wow.
He knows I don't play games. I'm from the north end of Toledo, Ohio. We don't play games. We go out in the park and we fight it out.
Right.
Let the best man win.
That's funny because he claims to be such a big tough guy.
Yeah, he runs from me.
Yeah. He just hides in his trailer.
Like I said, I'm 6 foot, 360 something pounds.
Right, right. I got you. And just so people know, again, we do have Andrea in the chat, as well as Jay Campbell is his cousin, Jennifer, right?
Yes.
Okay. And again, if Jennifer wants to ever come in.
Really, her husband's my cousin. She's my cousin-in-law.
Oh, I got you. To be technical, I got you. So,
hey, they take food, too. They take her food all the time.
Mm.
I went over and cooked breakfast for about 2 weeks ago. Yeah. Irby come over there and was eating off her plate.
Right off her very plate, literally.
Right off her very plate.
Isn't that wild? Well, I heard he was only feeding her twice a day, Schwann's microwavable meals or something.
Well, I caught her and all she was having was bologna sandwiches.
Isn't that outrageous?
And that was like 3 days in a row I caught her. I was, what are you eating for dinner, honey? Well, I'm having bologna sandwiches. I was like, you can't do that. You
three
need
days in a row.
A potato and a vegetable.
Mm-hmm. 3 days in a row, bologna sandwiches. That's what he was feeding her.
Yes.
And he's supposed to be the guy looking after.
Yeah, he don't look good. The only thing he's looking after is his money.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he seems to think that he's entitled to all that property. He thinks he's getting all that.
Yeah, he ain't getting none of it. And he's like, well, you're just blackmailing her. You're trying to blackmail her. You want it all. There ain't nothing she's got that I want besides love.
No, I
hear respect. When I get up to the pearly gates of heaven, I want her to be on the other side saying, here comes Larry. Here comes Larry.
No, I got you. So, on another note, too, we know that the kids have been taken again, right?
Yes.
That was about a week ago?
Yes. The day before the first.
Yeah, just before the first there. And what happened? Because there's rumors that, like, Jerry was hiding under the trailer and a bunch of stuff.
Well, I don't know about that, but I know CSB went out there to do a... Because the judge said she was going to do a thorough investigation on Irby. Because I told her that a lot of the money come up missing, her pills. She ain't been to see a doctor in 7 months.
Wow.
She ain't had no pills in 7 months. And to be honest, I think that's what he did to his wife, too.
Well, he did.
Let her see the doctor, wouldn't give her her pills, and it drove her nuts.
Well, he's trying to control.
Yeah, well... With Alice not having her pills, it could kill her quicker.
And that's murder.
Yeah. Well, it makes her brain. They're saying she's got that dementia moving in. So they got her on dementia pills. You take the dementia pill away, her dementia is just going to go real bad.
Wow. So he's trying to take her off the pills.
I bought them 2 weeks ago and I gave it to her and she took the first day. And I went over there like 2 days later to check on her to make sure she's taking them right. And we couldn't find them.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, all right, we looked for about an hour, couldn't find them. when I called her the next morning, I said, Alice, me and Joe's coming over and we're going to flip your house completely upside down until I find them pills. And you know, they were right where they were supposed to be when I walked in that house.
Oh, they magically reappeared.
Yeah, I magically reappeared there. So he's got one of her phones at his house.
Wow.
That way when I call, when we got the number changed, he blocked me twice from calling her.
Mm-hmm.
Said well, that I'm trying to put stuff in her head.
That's abuse. Like not like taking her off that medication, that is elderly.
Yeah, I know. Well, the judge will find about it. I talked to the lawyer and told the lawyer already.
And Andrea has confirmed that he did the same thing to her. He took her off the medication, wouldn't take her to the doctor.
Exactly. Yep. And I think that's why it happened. That's what, you know, I don't know if you guys know, but Andrea did hit Aunt Alice once and gave her a black eye.
Yeah.
And I hated Andrea for it. And I'm sorry, Andrea, that you're listening to this, but I think you already know. I've told you. I hated her guts for it. You don't hit no 85-year-old woman.
Right.
But Andrea wasn't on her pills. Andrea was not Andrea.
Mm-hmm.
She was a nutcase who was missing the medicines to keep her head straight.
Yep. And he does that on purpose. He's not dumb to that. He's doing that for a reason.
Oh, I know. To make him go crazy.
Mm-hmm. Then blame everybody else.
And then blame everybody else. He's the perfect one.
But I mean, like, there could be serious implications if Ma doesn't have her medication. Like, he wants her to be crazy so he can control it, right?
Yes.
That's sad.
It is. And that's well, when I turned around and when she told me that her light bill ain't been paid yet and it was almost $700 or no, telephone bill wasn't paid yet. And I was like, what? I called the phone company and they're like, oh yeah, you owe $700.
Wow.
So I went just down wasn't and paying I took the bills. Yeah, he wasn't paying them bills. Exactly. I think he was trying to get me to quit talking to her.
Well, yeah, he definitely doesn't want you guys in her ear.
No. Well, I'll be honest and I'll say it out clear. If it was me, I would put every property that I have up for sale. Sell it all, go live in some high-rise Jefferson place and order my steak and fries from the butler downstairs in the kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
Live like a rich hog until I died.
Well, there's no
whatever is left, I give to the Goodwill.
He hasn't worked in 30 years, right?
Yeah, exactly. Probably longer than that.
Wow. And he lets her, he even has a kid in North Dakota that he refuses to pay for.
No, she paid for him all of his life.
Uh-huh.
Alice paid for his child support all his life going up there.
Yep. And he just sits at home living like a prince.
Yeah, exactly.
The Prince of Lake Alice.
That's it. The Prince of Lake Alice.
So the kids were removed as part of they investigated, and you're not sure what they found, why they took the kids? Like, was it just that he lives in
school? Well, I mean, it could be a lot of different things. Alice has asked me about the same thing. I mean, it could be kids going to school dirty. Uh-huh. Could have been the kids going to school smelly. Could have been the way his house looked.
Yeah.
Well, the first day they went out there, as I was going to say, the two girls went out there from CSB, and his mom yelled for him. Well, who's them? Oh, they're trying to sell us something. We don't want to buy nothing. So I told him, go on down the road.
Right.
The next day, the state troopers came with the same girls.
Mm.
Them girls happened to be children's services wanting to see what his house looked like and wanted to see the kids, and he wouldn't let them.
Wow.
You don't let CSB in your house to see your house or your children. They're coming back with the cops and taking them.
Yeah, and he's threatened violence before. I have video of him saying he'd shoot them.
Yeah, exactly. And that's why they made sure the sheriff's office and the state highway patrol were both there.
And just for the record, I have no problem with people owning guns, but people like he's unbalanced. He shouldn't have guns. He's too violent.
Yeah, I agree. I agree.
Because he's pulled a gun before.
If you're a nutcase, you shouldn't have a gun.
Now, has he ever been diagnosed with anything officially?
I don't know. I really don't get into his life.
I got you.
I try to stay out of as much as possible. I'm worried about Miss Alice, and that's why I'm stepping up and doing what I got to do.
No, and I think that's very commendable. Again, Von Helton, we know you're watching. He's watching right now. And I know he has the link to join. He has the opportunity to come and say his piece. I will moderate fairly. But I'll bet 1,000 internet points he's not going to show up.
I won't take that bet because I don't want to lose no points.
I gotcha. Now, just as a little side note, I mean, there's
he might be able to call you out because you live 4,000 miles away. He calls me out. I could be in his front door in 2 minutes.
It's funny how that works, isn't it?
Yes.
Because I've actually had to serve him a cease and desist for physical threats that he's made against me.
That's how I got your name. That's how I was found a couple of you.
Yeah. Yeah, he's threatened.
He's always telling everybody, I got haters. I got haters. So I got on YouTube and started looking for haters.
No, there you go. Well, these are just people
are all perfectly right. Well,
I was going to say, most of these people you see he calls haters, someone that he's fucked over at least once on the internet.
Yeah, or they catch him in a lie.
Exactly. And he freaks out if you call him out on a lie.
Oh, I know. He starts yelling at me. And like I said, I'll tell him, I'll take you right outside. I don't care. Now, lose, or draw.
You told me some story, wasn't it, that you came over and he was yelling at Alice or something?
He come in the house yelling at Alice and me.
And what was
he yelling? Told him, I stood up in front of him when he got close enough to me. I stood up and I looked right at him, nose to nose. You yell at me one more time and I'm going to drag you outside and whip your ass.
Mm-hmm. And what was he yelling about?
I don't know. I didn't care. It's probably about me being there.
Oh, he's in a pissy mood because you were there.
Yeah. He don't like no one to go see her. He thinks that she's supposed to stay in that house and not talk to nobody, not see nobody, not go nowhere.
Okay. Apparently, Andrea wants to come in.
Let her come on in.
I'm trying to think of how to get a link to her. I could post it in the YouTube site, but I don't want any, you know, I don't want people flooding in here. So give me a sec.
Hell, I want everybody to know that he's a piece of shit.
Okay. Give me a sec here.
The other day, me and Jennifer and Joe, the ones that's over there watching too, the Jay Campbell.
Yeah.
We took her tablet over to Aunt Alice's and we're showing Alice some of the stuff he was saying.
Yeah.
She started crying and said, just turn it off. Turn it off. I can't watch it.
Isn't that wild?
Yeah.
Well, keep talking, Larry. I'm just going to take a minute here. I got Andrea put her email out, so I'm going to try to get her link to her. So I might be quiet for a minute.
All right. That'll work.
But, there's got to be other instances where he's lashed out.
To be a Frost, so now he's a Von Hilton. That must be nice. Maybe I should call myself Jesse James.
Yeah, true that.
Oh, okay, I thought you left me.
Well, I'm still listening.
Okay.
But I mean, there must be other times.
Why did he change the name? He goes, well, there ain't no good Hiltons in the world neither, so I went to Von Hilton.
No, that's wild.
I wish Andrea would have never got a divorce yet from his ass. I told her that today. You know why? Because if she was still married to him, she could walk in that bank account and get in that bank account. The banks couldn't stop her. She's got a marriage license saying she's married to him. Whatever belongs to the husband belongs to the wife. Honey, can you turn my fan on? Am I just getting hot or what? Might have turned our heat down or something. Turn the fan on. Well, I don't hear no one else talking to me, so it just must be me talking. This is Larry Frost talking to trying to get hold of that Vaughn Hilton. He likes to lie a lot. He likes to tell people stories. Well, I'm going to tell you the truth about him. He's a piece of scum. He lies about anything and everything. He says his mom don't do anything. His mom pays the light bill. His mom pays the water bill.
Is that okay? Can you feel it?
Okay. His mom has to pay somebody to come over and do the yard work. He throws garbage out on the back porch and we have to pay somebody to go over there and pick the garbage up out of the backyard because it looks like a pigsty. Just like the house. Come on, Vaughn Hilton. Where you at, buddy, old pal? You like to play on these computers. You like to be on YouTube and all this. Well, we're on what you like. I'm in your ball field now, boy. You won't come and play in my ball field. I'll come and play in yours. I don't care. I have nothing to hide from nobody. Hello. Well, you guys just listen then and relax. I would say it might not let you talk. I think it's just letting me and him. Vaughn never showed up. He's too chicken. He didn't accept the end. Yeah, oh, I know I am. I know I am. I'm telling him everything. There's 86 people watching right now. Yes. Well, we went to 118 watchers. I'm glad everyone's watching. Because I'm telling you all, Vaughn Hilton ain't nothing. Let me get off here. Let me get back on it. All right. Yep. Bye.
Okay. So the link has been sent to Andrea's email. Andrea, you're free. We'll help you get in here. But it's shocking.
Yeah, I just had a few other people saying they're watching, but they can't talk. And I was like, well, that's all right. Just listen to us.
Well, I mean,
promise, I know everything.
If something that wants to come in, you can share them. I'll trust you. You can share the link I gave you on Facebook.
I don't want to get off here because I'm scared I won't be able to get back on. I hear we got 118 people watching.
We do so. And Vaughn Hilton is one of them, guaranteed.
Yeah, I know he is. It just ain't showing him.
Well, he's sitting back listening. He's just not talking.
Yeah, he knows. He better not. I'm going to put him in his place.
Well, is there anything else you want to say to him? He's there. He's there in the crowd.
Well, I mean, I don't know what to say to him besides, you know, me and him's going to go round and round. He's probably going to jail. He's probably going to go to jail on March 19th with the kids. And then when he goes to court on April the 8th, he definitely might be staying in jail for a while.
So, yeah, you were mentioning you guys are going to court April 8th.
Yes, because on April 8th, he is trying to take custody from his mother. He wants full custody of his mother where he can control all the bills and he controls all the houses and he controls everything. She already told me she's not giving it up to nobody until the day she dies. And her will says the grandkids get everything. Yeah. All Irby gets is $200 a month for the rest of his life.
$200.
And honestly, he probably ain't even going to get that because he's already took $25,000 out of her bank account.
Yeah, he's been spending a lot of money on stuff.
Oh, yeah, I heard he bought a refrigerator and stove and UPS delivered it, $10,000 worth.
Oh, my goodness.
If it wasn't black, he didn't want it. It has to be a black refrigerator and stove.
Hey, what's Andrea.
Up? Hey.
It's good to see you.
Hi, Andrea.
Hello.
How you doing, girl?
Doing great.
Well, you've been listening good. To this?
Yeah, of course. I've been typing, too.
Yeah, now I can hear you, too.
So how have you been doing? It's been a long time.
I've been doing pretty good.
And do you have a new baby now?
Yep.
All right, on. And how's he doing?
He's sick right now.
Oh, yeah.
He's teething.
Oh, yeah.
They
have
put tubes in his ears.
Yeah, they get a little bit of a fever sometimes, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, what do you have to say about the whole situation? I mean, you lived with the man for 4 years. Does any of this sound familiar to you?
I believe he's paranoid and has lost his ever-loving mind.
I think he might have lost that a while ago, but it sounds similar to your situation with the medication and everything, right?
Yeah, he wouldn't give me my medication, and I begged him pretty for him to give me my meds, and he put them right on top of the fridge because he knows I can't reach up there.
So he'd make it difficult for you to take your medication.
Yeah. And now that I'm on my medicine, on the right meds, Andrew is back, and Andrew don't play like Larry.
The dynamic duo. Sorry, Larry, I had to mute you for a sec just because we're getting a bunch of echo, but that's okay. I'll unmute you here. But another question, Andrea. Have you had contact with Vaughn in the last few years or anything like that?
No, the last time I saw my kids was when they got taken away from CBS, and I was in the group home then.
Yeah.
And the judge is going to give them back to me, but the group home did not allow little kids there.
Huh. Yeah, that's for sure. And he took advantage of that situation.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah.
And then he's lying and saying I'm in a mental health facility.
Yeah.
I go to a day program at the mental health, but I'm not, all the way in the system.
Right, right.
I just go there, to have something to do during the day.
No, I get you. It's just an attempt to, defame you and, talk bad about you, right?
Yep. And as soon as I get my money saved, I'm going after him.
Yeah? You going to try to get some justice, Andrea?
Yeah.
Yeah. Justice for Andrea. Now, when you were with him, how did he treat Alice?
He would call her all kinds of ugly names.
Yeah, he talked bad about her quite a bit, didn't he?
Yep.
Didn't he talk bad about her to her face?
Yeah, he would call her all kinds of ugly names to her face.
Wow.
And get her all upset and everything.
Yeah.
There were times I just wanted to hit him.
And you think it was probably, he was manipulative. Like he tried to manipulate her.
Yeah, he was very manipulative.
Yeah, it's Vaughn's way or the highway, isn't it?
Yep. But he ain't getting his way for long.
No. Sounds like his time's coming.
It is.
Now, I'm just going to switch back to Larry. I'm going to unmute Larry for a second. I got a question for Larry.
Okay.
This is just kind of an off
I'm
thing.
I'm here.
Echo, folks, but we'll just deal through it here. I don't know if you're aware, but Vaughn Helton really likes his video games. And he plays one in particular.
You're breaking up on me.
Okay, can you hear me okay?
Okay, can you hear me okay?
Now you're better, yes.
Okay, I'll try this again.
Long story short,
we know for a fact that Vaughn Helton downloads these modifications for his video game that
right.
puts vaginas on the horses and allows dogs to, let's say, make love with females.
That I don't know. I don't go in his bedroom.
Well, it's just I found that very odd. I don't know why a man would have to put vaginas on a horse and make it so his dog could screw females in his video game.
I wouldn't know why someone would want to put it on any animal.
Exactly.
What do you think, Andrew? Did he ever do that kind of stuff, like mod his video games and stuff back in the day?
Yeah, he would use mods and stuff.
Would he use like sex mods and stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah. He's been into that for quite a while. I just think it's weird adding horse vaginas and like dog penises and stuff.
That's nasty.
Well, I'm just scared. Like, what if the kids just see that stuff?
Would the kids see that? You know, that's gonna mess with their head.
I think that's why he locks them out of their bed, out of his bedroom, and lets them do whatever they want.
Yeah. For hours.
And that's why that house looks like it does.
Mm-hmm. Well, Andrew, he used to get very upset if he didn't have his time on the internet, right?
Yeah.
Like, can you tell me of some behavior? Like, he used to rage quite a bit. Like, get very upset.
Yeah, he did. And it was made it hard for me to sleep. And I got so stressed out that I would get a migraine and it would paralyze me in bed. Yeah. And then he lied and said I was making it up. I don't, when I'm sick, I don't make up stuff like that.
Well, we have him on video telling you to go sleep in the car.
Yeah. And I'm like, no, I'm not going to sleep in the car. I'm going to sleep right here, you know?
That's wild. Tell your wife to go sleep in the car so you can go on the internet.
You know what my wife would tell me? I'm throwing your internet out the door.
Mm.
That's what I should have done. But see, I felt like I didn't want to say so because I was living, you know, with him. It was not really his property at the time, but you know,
you were his wife, not his property.
That's mm-hmm. what he viewed me as, his property.
You still have a mind to do whatever you want, girl.
Yep. And I ain't nobody's property.
Wow.
But the only person your property to is God.
Yep.
Now, he used to get really mad on the internet, but after he'd shut the internet off, he'd still be mad. He'd be all wound up, wouldn't he, Andrew?
Yeah.
Because he wasn't getting what he wanted.
Nope.
And he used to, the oldest daughter, Layla, she used to get pretty upset. Like, she got scared listening to him yell and scream, right?
That's why, like, I don't even make videos on YouTube.
Right.
I made, like, the opposite of him. Like, I made maybe one video on my old account. I have a new account now.
Right.
But, and that was, like, the only video, like, I ever made on YouTube. The others were, you know, when I just happened to be sitting there with him.
Jeez. Well, I just wonder what the kids think when they listen to him screaming and carrying on. And
I know they're scared of him. And I watched him beat them.
You watched him hit them?
Yeah, well, he would beat them with the belt.
What?
Yeah.
You should have called the law right there and then.
I was scared he might do something to me, too.
And then he would have went to jail.
Wow.
I mean, I should have done that, but I was sick at the time, and I wasn't thinking clearly.
Well, he shook.
Well, I will take it.
Didn't he, Andrea?
Huh?
He shook a fist in your face.
Yeah, he did.
Wow. So he used to strike the children with a belt.
Yeah. And leave marks on them.
Wow.
And then he's going to lie and sit there and say that I hurt my kids. I would never do that to my kids.
Well, yeah, he used to say that you were the one that hit them.
No. He's the one that did it.
Wow.
Last time I was there, the night before I got arrested. Because his mother called the sheriff on me.
Mm-hmm.
Last time I was there, I was sitting there playing with the kids. Like, I was playing with, coloring with them. I was doing, watching Layla do a jigsaw puzzle by herself. And I was coaching her on. I told her, you can do it. And she did it.
Oh, that's good. Good for her. But yeah. he would leave them.
I didn't clean their rooms because they refused to clean their room. I said, well, I'm going to clean their room. And I had it spotless.
Yeah. Well, you were left doing all the work every day, right?
Yeah.
Like, you did the laundry, you cleaned, you did the dishes, you looked after the kids, you washed the kids.
Yeah. And my mom would do the same thing, too. And good to sit there and play those little video games when my mom was up here.
Right. Yeah, she helped out quite a bit.
I'm not in Kentucky yet.
No, she helped out quite a bit when you lived there.
Yes, she did.
And he was pretty rude to her. I saw him mouth off at her a few times.
I know.
Isn't that, that's sad.
He is sad.
That's unreal. Now, do you think, like, as someone that's lived with Vaughn, do you think he would steal from his mom money?
I believe it.
Yeah.
I don't doubt it one bit.
No, you wouldn't. I wouldn't.
That's all he ever talked about was getting the properties and stuff.
Well, yeah, he used to talk about it back then. He was wringing his hands. He thought he'd see. What really disturbs me is if he's in charge of her medication, you know, and this is pretty serious stuff. And Vaughn Helton, again, you have the link. You are free to come in here. I know you're watching. And I want to give him the benefit of the doubt to give an explanation, because if he's manipulating the medication, like, that's a conspiracy to murder somebody, basically.
That is.
Larry, I'm going to bring you, I'm just going to unmute you for a sec, Larry. There you go. All right. What
do
you think? Like, that's a conspiracy to murder. Like, that's premeditated murder.
Yes, it is. Yes.
And you guys believe that he is capable of that kind of thought?
Honestly, yes.
I believe it. Like, I've gotten scared of him. Like, I mean, he's already... Proven to the court is dangerous.
Right. No, yeah, definitely. They know he's violent. I can't even believe they're entertaining the idea of him, like, taking over care for Ma Helton.
Well, she's denying it. She don't want it to happen. That's why she brought me back in the picture.
Excuse me. So she doesn't even want it.
No, she don't want him to have no power.
No.
So Vaughn Helton is the only person in this whole thing that wants to have power.
Yeah, exactly.
And then it's going to be a match if he don't get his way, and I'm scared of what he's going to do to, like, the kids and to her.
Well, he ain't going to do nothing to her, and he ain't going to do nothing to the kids, because the kids are gone.
Yeah.
Them kids are going home with you on the 19th.
Hopefully.
Well, I'm going to be in that courtroom, girl.
I know.
I will be in that courtroom.
Unreal.
Yeah, my young son is adopted. I signed the adoption papers.
Mm-hmm.
To keep him in the family, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And he's doing really great. Other than being sick. He's almost walking.
Oh, wow. Good. So he's being looked after by a family member, and you're involved in his life.
Yeah, I have legal visitation on him, and I've not heard him not once.
Well, that's good.
I don't allow myself or even think about hurting another kid. Even if it, even my kid, you know, I would never do that to him.
Yeah. Well, yeah, like we were saying, he already has one child he's neglecting in North Dakota.
They're gonna go after him too.
Well, they can't no more. He's 18 now.
Oh, he is?
Yeah, he's 18. She don't have to pay child support no more.
Well, Ma's been paying that.
Yeah, Ma's paid all that.
Yeah, she did.
And then it's only a 50-50.
Doing that.
And it's only a 50-50 chance that it's his.
Yeah. I believe
there was no DNA test taken for it.
Yep.
Well, he always claimed that there was, but that the kid was a clone or something.
Yeah, I don't know about that, but he told me it was his kid, and I was like, well, did you do blood work? He goes, oh, they got a piece of hair from my hairbrush that I left there 2 years ago. How many people's used that hairbrush since he has?
What did he tell you, Andrea?
He told me that all they had to do was all she had to do was get a piece of his DNA, send it to the mail, and, you know, send it to wherever place they sent it to, and they would know no different.
Yeah, well, that's his excuse, right? That's when he was trying to get out of it.
Instead of,
well, you know, if I'm
stepping
gonna spend
up and
30,
not being a parent, he's going to sit there and be a coward.
Well, if I'm going to spend $30,000 on child support, I'm going up there to prove that I'm the parent first.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what you're supposed to
there
do.
There ain't no sending nothing in the mail. I am driving up there and doing a swab test right at Children's Services.
Well, you know why Vaughn wasn't that concerned? It was because Ma was paying the bill. He don't give a fuck.
Right, right, exactly.
He is not a good parent.
Hell no.
I hear he's got about $20,000 in debt with the college that he went to.
Well, that's his big excuse for not working.
Single one of them.
Yeah.
And I'm in college right now, and I know that it's my responsibility when I graduate to pay the loans back.
Yeah. So you're in college right now?
I'm trying to get student loans, but I'm responsible enough to be able to pay them back, unlike him.
What are you thinking in college, Andrea?
I'm going for business administration.
Oh, good. Good for you.
And I have a 3.11 GPA.
Oh, great.
That's good.
Yep. So there's nothing wrong with my intelligence, but I have serious doubts about his.
No, definitely. Well, it sounds like you've definitely, your life is.
You know, I think the funniest part is he's looking for girlfriend.
Yeah. And that's what I noticed when he's. When I, we were married, and I
look if she's he's not interested.
No, they're not.
If she's 18 to 21, he's interested. After 21, he don't want nothing to do with them. To me, that's child molestation.
That is, especially when one of them isn't of legal age.
Honey, he's 55 years old. He shouldn't be with no 18-year-old girl.
Somebody's on age.
He's not Hugh Hefner.
Nope.
Yeah, definitely not.
And I think Hugh Hefner only has him because of that big fat pay money he's got.
Probably, but...
I mean, when you live in a 30-bedroom home, then Hugh Hefner can have some of them beautiful women come and live with him.
Yep.
Irvy don't live in no 30-bedroom home.
Nope.
Mm-hmm. Well, as I stated before, Von Helton, I know you're watching. You have a chance to come in here. You have the link. If what they're saying is not true, you have the right and the opportunity to defend yourself right now live.
I don't even think he knows how to repent.
Yeah, come on, Von Hilton. Come out here and tell everybody we're lying.
You're not. I'm surprised.
Come on, Von.
I told you.
He ain't going to get on.
He's a coward.
If you would have said that it was you and him, he might have got on. But with my name involved, he wasn't coming nowhere near it.
He's scared of you.
Yeah. Because he knows I don't play. My mom and dad taught me not to play with nobody.
Yeah, I don't play mind games. I don't have time for that.
He tells me I don't know how to raise kids, but I got 5 gorgeous boys, and they're all of age.
Yeah.
And that's what he says. Well, that's why your house stays clean, because your kids are 15 and 17 and moved out. And I was like, I had to teach
them.
I had to teach them when they were babies.
Yep. That's what you're supposed to do.
When they're done with their toys, you tell them to put them toys away.
And if they don't, sit them in the corner for timeout.
No, I put them all in a garbage bag and tell them I'm throwing them in the garbage.
Well,
if they can't pick up their toys and put them in the toy box where they belong, I will throw them away.
No, I mean, you should do that too.
And I guarantee you, after 2 times of losing their favorite toys, they start picking them toys up.
Yep.
Wow. I heard he's spending a lot of money on them cars, too, he's been buying.
Yeah, and actually, Larry, after we're done, if not tonight, tomorrow, I'm going to provide you with links where Von, all the nooks and crannies on the internet where Von Helton hangs out.
Okay, that'll work for me because I'm going to post all of them.
Because he has a video, he has a video channel on a site called BitTube.tv, and he posts all these.
Yeah, I told the CPS lady about BitTube.
Yeah, and he posts all his Hot Wheels, big hauls, boxes and boxes of them he's been buying. In his barn,
he's got them all up in his
to build tables.
And
he set up a big Hot Wheels track.
Right. Yeah, I've seen it.
Needs to be spending it on the kids.
Well, yeah. Well, Jerry could use that money for therapy.
Yeah, for a special teacher.
Mm. Oh, well, that's where he's getting the money. Jerry's money.
I know. And I'm sitting there.
Like, and his mom.
I watched one of his videos, and I'm sitting there like, where's he getting all this money from? And then he likes in there, he's like talking about he had his truck. I'm like, huh? I'm like, I didn't know what was going on in the background.
I just want to jump in for a sec. I want to clear up some confusion in the chat. BitTube TV is where Von posts his racing cars. And on BitChute.com, that's where he puts his crazy conspiracy stuff.
Well, I told her, I told the head CBS lady about BitChute. So he's
going
to be watching it.
Okay.
Well, I've seen everything he's put out on YouTube.
I saw a couple of them, and it made me so mad about him sitting there talking crap about me and everything. And I haven't seen him in years, and I've got nothing to him. And I'm like, that's it. You want to sit there and swing at me, go ahead, but I'm going to find a wall and go after you.
Mm-hmm. Well, when he started shaking his fist in your face and threatening you with guns and stuff, I think that was a line too far. That was a step too far for sure.
Yeah, that was a trigger for me to get weed, you know, to get out.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like,
no matter how, you get out of there.
That's what I was thinking, trying to figure out how. And I'm like, the only thing I need to do was to get one of my, the guy I met online to come pick me up. There was nothing going on between us.
Well, and that was up to you, girl. I would have dialed 911. I would have dialed 911, had him arrested, and you'd still be sitting there with your kids right now.
I know. That's where I messed up. But I learned from that.
Well, and that's what we all do. We all learn.
Yep.
Life is a learning thing.
Yep.
And just to be clear, too, when we're talking about the Hot Wheels and whatnot, we're not, it's not the fact that he's into Hot Wheels or makes videos. That's fine. But the question is, how is he financing it? Because he spent thousands within months.
Right.
He's not.
Hello.
Financing it.
Hey. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. I'll bring that up here in a minute. Give me a minute.
Okay.
All right, bye. Okay. Jennifer just called me and was reminding me to tell everybody about he's God because he's saying we're going to hell.
I've already been to heaven because I died twice in operation table, so... God's got my back, but I'm...
Well, my opinion, my God's more powerful than his.
Well, he's threatening you with hell, but he claims he's not even a Christian. He says he's a fucking pagan or something.
Yeah. He's a warlock. That's what he called me.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, he's a welfare warlock.
Well, yeah, well, not no more because he's losing all that.
Yep.
He ain't got the kids. He ain't getting no checks or food stamps.
And well, that's kind of thing.
As soon as I get my kids back, I'm off of security and let them know what's up.
Mm-hmm. Because, oh, like, honey, we always already feeling, know.
Sorry.
We always had the feeling he kind of looked at the kids as a paycheck. Like, that's kind of why he wants lots of kids,
that's
right?
That's what it was.
wants
yep.
kids, right?
Yep. He got paycheck.
It's all about those Benjamins.
It's all about those Benjamins.
Yep, $770 in cash and over 500 in stamps.
Oh, Lord.
That's pretty good when you're not paying rent.
That's pretty good when you're not paying rent.
Yeah. The only bill he pays, honestly, is his telephone bill, his cable and internet.
Of course.
And that's out of the kids' money anyway.
He don't pay rent. His mom pays the lights. His mom pays the water. His mom mm-hmm. even has to pay the lawn service to come in and cut it because he's too lazy to go cut the grass.
Teddy's yep. allergic to his son. I don't believe that one bit.
And she's got a $3,500 lawnmower that's one of them circle turn things.
Oh, those are fun to drive.
Yeah, she's got one of them brand spanking new. Ain't a year old.
Oh, wow.
Hmm. I've heard that too, Andrea. He says he's allergic to the sun.
Yeah.
He says he's allergic to garlic too.
Yeah, that's what he.
He's allergic to garlic too.
Yeah. That's why
he ate garlic bread before, and they didn't breathe in hard him. So I know that was a lie. That's all he knows how to do is lie.
That's all he knows how to do is lie.
And this lie's about to catch up on him, too.
Well, I was hoping to catch him tonight, but it looks like he's too scared to get on.
Yeah, he's watching. I know for a fact he's watching. He has the link. Come on,
yeah, he's just sitting there listening.
Probably another account or something.
Well, he doesn't even have to see in the chat.
Mine don't show names.
He could just be watching. He's lurking. He's watching.
And I don't care what he has to say about me because I know that it's true. And now it just goes right back to him. Reverse psychology.
Right. And I listen. And again, genuinely, I want to give Von Held the opportunity to respond to this. Because I'm going to be totally fair. I don't know you guys. You know, I'm just giving the opportunity to say your piece. And I give him his opportunity. But I think his silence is deafening, the fact that he won't come in. I would just think if I was innocent, I would want to come in and challenge this.
Yeah, if somebody was talking bad about me, I'm going to come in and challenge you. Exactly.
Yeah.
The silence is deafening.
He needs to go ahead and say it. And get it over with.
That's right, Andrea. Just like a Band-Aid. Pull it off quick.
Yep. It ain't going to hurt my feelings, what he has to say.
I hear you.
Wait till I have to hear what
like I said. I think he... I think the only problem is he knows I'm like 2 minutes away from his house. I could be there like a blink of my eyes.
Yeah.
Larry, do you know much about Von's military service?
He did 6 months and got kicked out.
He did get kicked out.
He got kicked out at 6 months.
And he got, what did he get kicked out? Just not being able to do it? Or was there an altercation? Or a
person? They said that they really didn't know. And then I had my uncle tell me that he was a nutcase or they threw him out.
Oh, just acting up all the time and probably raging out. And
yes, yes.
Yeah.
Wouldn't follow directions, wouldn't do what he was told. Thought he was the sergeant instead of a rookie.
Well, he did tell a story about how he got in a fight with a sergeant or something. And his version of the story, of course, is that a sergeant and somebody else was related and they worked to get him out of the army or something like that. They were trying to give him a hard time.
Yeah, I don't think they do that.
He also claimed that he worked as special ops after and he traveled around America fighting pimps.
No way.
No.
If he's all...
Oh, we got a reload happening. Uh-oh, Larry dropped out. Well, Andrew, what do you think? Like, what do you have to add to this whole situation? I don't know if Andrea hears me. Okay. Can you hear me at all? Can the people out there hear me? Oh, we got Larry coming back.
You got Larry back there?
Yeah, we got you.
I'm back. Had a glimpse in the website.
Well, maybe Vaughn was trying to get you. He was zapping you with his vampire powers.
Yeah, that could be it. He's sending the devil this way.
Yeah, the devil he doesn't believe in.
Yeah. Well, the devil better watch what he's doing because I got a lot of crosses.
Well, here comes Andrea back. Let's see if we can get this happening again. Can you hear us, Andrea?
You think they might have kicked us because we've been on an hour?
Oh, no. I got lots of time. Okay. We're live.
Yeah, I see we're live now, but I mean, it like it just kicked us both.
Well, she reloaded.
Okay.
She's having audio problems. She's talking, but I don't hear anything. Andrea, you might have to go into your audio settings and reset your mic or something. But I don't know, Larry. Do you got anything else to share? Because it's looking like he's going to be a coward here, and he doesn't want to.
No, not really. I just wanted to get out there what's been going on and tell everybody who says he's lying, they're definitely right. He is lying.
Right.
He is taking his mom for everything she's got. At least he's trying, but I'm not letting him.
Right. And again, that opportunity is there for Vaughn to come in and dismiss this. I mean, if this, again, you know, I'm giving everybody the benefit of the doubt. We're just putting the news out there. I'm not saying one way or the other, but I do think that it's quite a statement not to show up.
Right, right. Well, it's just like he said, my Uncle Little Jim stole like $50,000 from Alice about 8 months ago because a lot of money come up missing. But what would Jim do with money? Jim's got money.
Right, and Jim was the executor, wasn't he?
Yes, he was the executor of the will and everything. He was her power of attorney.
Yeah, he was trying to claim that Jim was trying to rip her off and this and that.
Yeah, Jim can't even handle the 40 acres and the two houses he has, let alone someone else's stuff.
Right.
Right.
And then I told him, well, he don't like Jim. I got another cousin that makes Alice look like a welfare case.
Right.
And she ain't nowhere near a welfare case, but I got two or three cousins that make her look like a welfare case.
Right. So basically, if they're going to target someone for money, there's other targets in the family that have more money, right?
Well, yeah. I mean, if someone's going to be executive of the will or someone's going to be power of attorney, if he thinks that little Jim, because little Jim ain't got all that kind of money, then we'll give it to somebody who has that kind of money. He makes Alice look like a welfare case. This man brings in more money than Alice is going to collect for 6 months.
Right. So he doesn't have the motivation to steal it. Whereas Vaughn has all kinds of motivation.
Right. Well, I ain't told him. If I told him what Vaughn's been doing, well, between me and you and Vaughn, you could hear this clear as day, buddy. The day we lower your mom in the coffin, there's 6 family members that are going to take you out. There's 14 of your neighbors going to take you out.
So the neighbors are upset with them too?
Oh, all of them.
Nobody
likes
Vaughn.
Nobody down here that likes him at all.
Wow. He's burnt that many bridges.
He's burned all the bridges.
And is it just being nasty to people?
Being nasty to people, being nasty to his mother.
Mm-hmm. Well, they
way he talks about her.
Yeah, well, I've seen him on video call her a bitch and call her this and that.
Well, you know, I don't know if you know, but we're from a very small town.
Right.
I mean, we got a little elementary school, we have a post office, and we got a gas station, which is a carryout. He went up and bought $600 worth of lottery last month.
Lottery tickets?
At one time. $600 worth.
Wow. Because he's been saying he's going to win the lottery.
Yeah, yeah. Well, all that money was his mom's money. And he acts like he ain't going to let nobody know. Well, when you walk into that carryout, that's like walking into the paper. She tells everybody everything.
And everybody knows.
I can go in there and say, well, I can go in there right now and say, Irby stole $1,000 from his mom today. By tomorrow morning, the whole town knows that he stole $1,000 from his mom.
And he's not helping his case by walking in like a man that has no income is walking in and in one sitting buying $600 of lottery tickets.
Yeah, exactly. When he ain't got no money, he don't work.
And of course,
that's why she told me. She goes, that's why she come and told me. She goes, Larry, your cousin was just in here. He bought over $600 worth of lottery tickets.
Wow.
Don't put me wrong. I try to play too, but I don't spend no more than $10.
Well, it's your money.
I got a family to feed. I got bills to pay.
Yeah, the thing is, it's not even his money. Andrea, we can't hear you.
No, that's not even his money. Yeah.
Andrea, we can't hear you.
You might have to go in the cam mic settings.
You might have to go in the cam mic settings.
And reselect your microphone.
And reselect your microphone.
Nope. We see your lips moving.
We see your lips moving.
I don't know what happened. And we'll try to get it figured out. But yeah. But Von Held, we know you're watching again. I don't know. You know, maybe he's got some excuses. Maybe he found $600. Under a rock by Lake Allen.
Yeah, yeah. The rock up under her front porch, maybe.
Yeah, in a jar or something. But I mean, the opportunity is there if he's got a story to tell and he has an explanation. So that's
His explanations are all lies.
Mm-hmm.
That's like he told Alice, I never went in your house when they were remodeling it. Little Jim said he was there every day.
Keeping an eye.
He made a bet with me one day. He told me, he says, well, I know little Jim's going to take everything as soon as my mom dies. Jim's taking it off. And to be honest, I don't bet unless I know it's a surefire thing. He goes, I'll shake your hand for $1,000 that Jim takes everything. I stood up, got up there in one hand, knowing that the day before that, little Jim gave power of attorney away. Jim took $167 out of his own pocket. And took power of attorney off of him.
Well, I can hear you now.
Yeah, I can hear you too.
Jim didn't want the headache.
Yeah, I can hear you too.
But yeah.
You back, girl?
I'm back.
I'm back.
Okay.
He's so lazy and selfish and self-centered.
Yeah, we're waiting for that lazy husband still. Ex-husband, sorry.
Yeah, ex-husband. Guess what, second opinion?
What's that?
I'm engaged.
Oh, well, congratulations.
And we already set a date.
And you know, I already told you that, girl.
And I told my fiance about how ex-husband's treating me, and he does not like that at all.
Well, no man's going to.
I know.
Not if they're a man.
And there's Von Helton sitting in his trailer playing with horse vaginas on a video game.
I know, it's so nasty.
What is wrong with that guy?
He's psycho.
Now, do you think, Larry, that growing up, maybe Ma spoiled him or coddled him too much or something?
I was going to say the same thing. I think his mommy and daddy spoiled him rotten when he was a little boy and never disciplined him at all, and that's why he became the way he is.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, when I get up to the court, I'm going to get the divorce papers and the marriage license and get my name changed back to my maiden name.
Excellent.
Well, you don't want to get your marriage license here. You want to get them in Alabama where you guys live.
No, I thought we got married in Kentucky, though. I had to go to the courthouse and get them because they have them.
You got to go to the courthouse to get the divorce papers.
Well, in order to change my name, I have to have the marriage license too. I already talked to Social Security and the policeman down here. Because I'm going to try to get
my they ain't going to give you a marriage license if you're already divorced.
Are they not?
If you're already divorced, they can't give you the marriage license.
Oh, I didn't know that, but.
But if you're getting ready to, if you're getting ready to marry somebody else, then you need to get them court papers from that court justice. So you live in Alabama, you need your Alabama court.
Yeah.
But you'll have to get your divorce papers up here showing your divorce and you're able to get remarried.
That's what I'm doing.
Well, that's good. Will it be a summertime wedding?
No, it's going to be... We got it planned for May the 4th.
Springtime.
Hey, that's just right around the corner.
Yep. Oh. That's why I'm going to be booking it to get the divorce papers.
You must be excited.
I am. Well, I've only waited 4 years for my fiance to ask me that question. And she said, go ahead.
At least he's a man and he asked for permission.
Yep. He's never married before. I had to kind of encourage him because he didn't know what to do. I said, did you have something to ask my mom? And he's like, what? I'm like, I've never married before. I don't know what to do. I'm like, well, here's a bit of encouragement for you. And I encouraged him to ask my mom.
Your mom didn't really care much for you.
Oh, she cares. She knows how much I'm in love with him and everything.
No, I meant James Von Helton. She didn't like him.
She did not.
He was rude to her a few times, too, eh?
Yeah.
What kinds of things would he say?
I can't say much about that.
Right. No, fair enough, Larry. But Andrea, like, what kind of things would he say to your mom when he was mad?
Do what?
What kind of things would Von Helton say to your mom when he was mad at her?
He may not have to say much about to her because he knew I'd say something.
Right.
And then he's trying to like brainwash the kid and make him his enemy when I'm not.
Right.
Think that that it was my mom that ran me off when it was really him.
Yeah, and just to clear the air too, like the quote unquote internet trolls didn't like brainwash you to leave Von Helton, correct?
Correct. He did not brainwash me.
Yeah.
The only thing I needed to do was to leave, and I knew that this person would come get me when he heard him in the background. So threatening to kill me.
Mm-hmm. That's when John Chacon came into the picture.
Yeah, I don't even talk to John anymore. Like.
Well, he helped you out, though.
Yeah, he helped me out.
Well, that was good. Wow. Well, again,
that's when you know that's when you know there's good people out there.
Yeah. Sometimes I forget that there's good people out there.
Yeah.
I'm opening up to it now. Yeah, there's actually people out there willing to help me.
Yeah. Well, that's good.
Get my kids back.
Well, like I said, girl, the 19th of this month, you're coming up here to come and try to take these kids. And I'm on your side. I told you what to tell the judge.
You might have to remind me again because,
tell them that you live in a small apartment now, but as soon as your kids come home, you will start looking for something bigger.
Yeah, they're going to be good and well taken care of.
Because that's the first thing they're going to look at is where you live and is it big enough for you to have a family home.
I mean, my mom's trying to find another big enough place.
You know, I've been part of Children's Services. I know all about them people.
I know what they're going to say. Right now, I'm like living in a one-bedroom apartment with my mom, but I'm not gonna be living with my mom for long, though.
Right, exactly. So if you get your kids back, tell them you're gonna get yourself a place.
Huh? What'd you say?
Well, you know, you can look into them housing projects down there too.
Well, I'm going to be moving in with my fiance. He's got two bedrooms. Apartment.
Well, you're going to have to get a little... You might have to get something bigger.
That's what I told him.
Because the girls are going to need a room, and Jerry's going to need his own room. They cannot be in the same bedroom. Same room.
And down here, I think it's 8-7 where they have to have their own room.
If you had three or four girls, then you could put them all in the same room. But being a boy and girls together, you cannot put them together.
No, you can't. I'll talk to my fiance more about that. But I'm waiting to see what happens on the 19th.
Well, that's the main thing. Wait until the 19th.
Then I want to talk to him about it.
Like I said, I'm going to be there, and I'm going to tell the judge what I think. They should go with you. And then with Jerry's check coming into you, you should be able to pay your bills.
Yep.
You should be able to take good care of them kids.
I'm going to. I'm spoiled, but not as much the way girls are spoiled. I'm going to train them to be good Christian people. You know, good Christian kids. They're going to be going to a good church.
Come on, Vaughn Hilton. Where you at? About to talk to you.
Where you at, coward?
Vaughn. Yeah, where you at, coward?
The coward of Clay County.
The coward of Clay County.
The coward of Clay County. Kentucky. The coward of Clay County. I didn't know this, but there's a Clay County, Alabama.
There's a lot of the Clay counties all over the United States.
Yeah, I didn't know that until I checked the map.
Yeah, there's like 11 or 12 of them.
And I'm like, wow, you know.
Hey, I looked up my own name one day, and I come up with 42 of them.
Yeah, there's a lot of
42
people
Larry Frosses. There's 42 Larry Frosses.
Wow.
And they live all around the United States. And funny thing, I'm friends with four of them.
I saw that when you were talking to the person. And I'm like, who's that? You had got me all confused.
So Larry, I got a cousin named Larry Frost.
Larry, I got a question. That? Just a little off topic, but I just wanted to ask you about like years back. Vaughn's first wife, Pam. What never happened?
Met her.
You never met her?
You never met her?
No.
I haven't either.
When I met Vaughn probably about 12 years ago.
Okay.
And he was living in that trailer by himself, pushing on the internet for 18 to 21 year old girls to be his girlfriend.
Yeah.
And he come out for a family. The main reason I come down here is a family reunion. I love the weather. I love the scenery. I love the peace and quiet. I mean, my town, we're lucky if we got 50 people.
Yeah.
In this whole 20-mile radius, there's 40 people.
Right.
And when I first met him, his hair was probably middle of his back. His fingernails were probably longer than his whole fingers.
Yeah, he used to do the long fingernail thing.
I don't like long fingernails.
Yeah, yeah. And his mom yelled at him about it during the family reunion. And I was like, well, buddy, you know, she just wants you to look decent in front of the family. Why don't you go brush your hair, put it in a ponytail, and put it up in a hat? He goes, Larry, you don't know what you're talking about. I took my hat off and my hair is longer than his.
Wow.
That's wild.
So he couldn't tell me. That's what I'm saying. He says, I don't know what I'm talking about. Why I'm through it.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't pampered by my mommy and daddy and was given everything by a silver spoon or the gold spoon.
Right.
I had to get out and work my ass. When I was 16 years old, I was still staying at my parents' house. I got a job and I had to pay rent.
Yeah, that's how it goes.
Yep.
And if I wasn't paying rent, then I can get out.
Well, I mean,
and then they seen my food appetite, and then they were like, well, you're pitching in on food too.
Well, I mean, this thing, what's he going to do once Alice goes? Because, I mean, the guy has not held a job in his adult life since, like, delivering pizza or something like that. Like, what?
He thinks he's going to live off them houses.
And he ain't going to be able to do that.
No, he ain't, because them houses are willed to your children.
Yep.
He will get $4 a month for the rest of his life. That is. I've seen now, it's already in her lawyer's hands.
If the estate is left to the children, if the estate is left to the children and he,
well, that you know,
he's guardian of them, don't they get to stay there?
Well, if he's got guardian, yes, he could stay there. But if she gets them, then all the money will go in a safety deposit box. And if it needs a hot water tank, I'll go get the hot water tank. When them kids start turning 18 years old, it goes to the kids.
Yep.
And in the it says they cannot property at all.
Wouldn't it be ironic, Andrea, if you got
in Alabama, the kids had to rent these properties out?
Wouldn't it be ironic, Andrea, if you got custody of the kids and Vaughn got kicked off the property and you moved into the double wide?
Yeah, that would be something.
Well, Vaughn's mom told me the other day she was thinking about throwing Irby out of that house and moving her in it. Because she wants her grandkids back. She don't worry about Irby. She wants the grandkids.
Yeah, this must be hard on her.
She loves him to death.
Yeah, that's sad. Well,
he's going around whining and saying that he's pulling on their hair and everything.
Yeah. Well, Vaughn Helton, you have the opportunity. I mean, if these people are lying on you and... you know, this is all fallacious, then, I mean, come on in. I'll moderate. I'll make sure it's fair and you have your floor.
So fallacious, then, I mean, come on in. I'll moderate. I'll make sure it's fair and you have your floor.
Yeah, we'll give him his time. We'll let him talk.
I mean, he's been talking a lot of shit around the internet about the locals.
You talk bad.
He's been talking a lot of shit around the internet about the locals.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, if he don't show up, then that just means that we're telling the truth.
He likes to talk a lot of shit about the family, but when the family's here, he don't even show up.
Well, I'm sure he'll find a venue. He can, like I said, Larry, I'll give you some links later for all the little places he hangs out and people that let him come on.
So maybe
he'll catch him live.
Yeah, I'll catch him in one of them lies. I'm one of them and get in on it.
But he's been pretty quiet the last week. I have to say, that's a sign that something's going on. He hasn't been online as much as he usually is.
Well, I seen him leaking something about, and I was like, well, have you called him yet? He goes, called who? I was like, Children's Services. Ain't that who took him? He goes, yeah. I said, you call him yet? I don't know their number. I don't know how to get a hold of them. Buddy, it's in the telephone book. Get on Google and say Children's Services, Manchester, Kentucky.
Well, he's dealt with them for
a
decade.
He's so smart on the computer, but he don't Google it.
Well, he's dealt with them for a decade.
Yeah, he should have their number by heart, huh?
Yeah, many times.
But it was 4 days after they took him. Tell you, someone comes out here and takes my kids, I will be there before they get there with my kids.
I've noticed, and Andrea, maybe
my kids without explaining why they took mine.
Andrew, maybe you can have something to say about this, but I've always noticed that when the kids are gone, he seems kind of blasé about getting them back, almost like he looks at it like a mini vacation.
That's exactly the way he looks at them.
Well, you know he got their check and their food stamps this month. Next month's what's going to get to him.
Yep.
Benny's going to start going off and saying he's going to sue the whole city of Manchester.
Yeah. He's just going off. He thinks I'm already in Kentucky.
Well, Social Security has been notified, and so is welfare.
That's good.
Blessed Bible Fight Club. In the chat, aka Bruce, if I can say, I think that's his first name. I don't know if I've ever had many conversations with a guy, but he says that Yvonne's too uncomfortable to come in here after I shut this down. He's welcome to go in there and vent, say his piece, but you know, and that. So I'm just putting that out there. But you got the link to this, Vaughn. I mean, your accusers are right here. You have your chance to face your accusers.
Yeah, you got something to say? Say it. We'll let you say it. I'll keep my mouth shut for 5 minutes.
Me too.
But if he talks anything about my kids or wife, I'm going to your house. And he knows I will.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not shy.
Yep.
As my wife called here.
Yep.
That's what my wife calls me, the grizzly bear.
Mm-hmm.
Look out, Vaughn.
Look out, Vaughn.
Well, Andrew, I'm really glad that you're looking better and you're happier and you've got some focus in your life and some goals. I'm really glad to hear that.
Yeah.
It's a difference that a few years makes.
Sure does.
The difference the medicine makes.
It's the medicine makes.
Yeah.
Yep.
The medicine's making her good.
Yep.
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 She's been taking that medicine like she's supposed to, and she's doing good.
Exactly, and that's the biggest concern with Alice right now, just to kind of bring it back to our original points, because that is serious. If that allegation is true, then he's messing with her medication.
Yeah.
He could be liable for some...
Well, I don't lie. I don't lie at all about nothing.
Now you sure don't. Now you sure don't.
Yeah. I'm as real as they get.
Well, Von Helton has been known as quite a storyteller over the years, that's for sure.
Well, I've seen a lot of them. That's why I've been looking for him to put him in his place.
Now, when he's out around the family and that, does he try to tell them that he's a vampire and that he's the Punisher and all this shit?
When the family comes around, he goes in his trailer and he won't come out.
Mm-hmm.
So zero interaction.
He hides in the trailer. No interaction with the family. He ain't a Frost, because I am a Frost. And he's mm-hmm. not a Hilton. He's a Von Hilton.
Yeah, that's what he said.
So has there ever been any more like instances, like when that cousin came down and he pulled a gun? Has he ever had any other freakouts of family members?
Not that I know of, because the rest of them all carry their own guns, and I think he knows if he pulls a gun out on one of them, they're going to shoot him.
But has he even had like any fights?
No. Well, Little Jim wanted him one time, but Little Jim says no, it wasn't worth it.
Yeah, he's not worth it.
Well, me, I don't care if I go to jail. I've been to jail 100 times, and I'll go 100 more. I don't care.
Now, Von Helton also claims to be related to Ted Nugent.
That's what he told me, too.
Larry, have you ever heard that he's related to Ted Nugent?
Oh, we got quiet.
I don't know if Larry can hear me.
Did he leave us? No, it shows we're still live.
Andrea, can you hear me?
Yeah.
I think Larry has lost audio.
Maybe he's got Von Hilton on the other line. Can you hear me, girl?
Yeah.
I can't hear you. I seen your lips move.
Can you hear me, Secure?
Give me the peace sign if you can hear me. I can't hear a word you're saying. I see his picture, but I don't hear him talking at all.
He'll probably have to reload.
Can you hear me?
He might have had to go to the bathroom. We'll give him a minute. Come on, Von Hilton. Where you at, buddy, old pal? Let's have this talk out. We can talk about whatever you want. About you going to the war for 2 years is a lie. Jim stealing Alice's money is a lie. You stealing Alice's money is all true. Hello? Is that what he said? Okay, I'm doing that right now. Off.
I think Cousin Jen got the message through. I was going to start using smoke signals here in a second.
Get it out of there. Come on. Yes.
We're working on it, folks. By the way, for anyone interested, I think I might have a Nick Bravo Part 2 lined up for this Wednesday. Punchy and Happy Jesus, if you're listening, Nick Bravo has agreed. Aiming for Wednesday afternoon.
Yeah. I mean, am I forgetting anything?
Wednesday afternoon.
I hear him now. I'm here. Oh. I'm back. Bye.
We got her.
I'm back.
I can hear you.
Von Hilton.
I think he froze.
I think he's having some connection issues.
Yeah.
All my mirrors, if you want to in on the Bravo interview part two, you're more than welcome to come. Just let me know. Hit me up over in Trolls, Haters, and Naysayers. Because we're such evil people, according to Von Helton. We're all evil.
When in reality, we're good people.
I don't think we're ever that really mean to him. We just criticize him for being a liar.
Yeah.
Pretty much. He made it a bigger deal than it was, didn't he?
Yeah.
He tries to say that it was us that gave you problems, but it was him with the medication and the way he was treating you.
Exactly.
It's just what kind of guy he is. Okay, folks, I'm going to try to get a message and a link to Larry. They're saying that Vaughn is live. He was too much of a coward to come here, but he may be over at the Blessed Bible Fight Club. Hey, Doc Savage. Looks like the party is moving over. We got to get Larry a link so he can get in on the action. But
can I go too?
Yeah, so in the chat, Andrea, you see they're posting the YouTube.
Hang on.
Maybe Jen can help them out, but I'm going to shut this.
Send me the link.
Okay, we're going to work on this. We're going to get this coordinated. Okay, folks, thanks for watching. We're going to move on over and see part two of this, how it plays out.
Where's the link?
Okay.
Just give me a sec. Actually, just give me a sec. Maybe I can get the YouTube.
We're going to go to part two now. We're going over there. All right. Bye.
I'm going to show the link.
Okay.
Okay. Just give me a sec.
Maybe
I can get the YouTube. We're going to go to part two now. We're going over there. But I can't seem to grab it from here for some reason for myself.
Okay.
But that's the YouTube link, folks. I'm just going to shut down instead of piping it through.
Hang on, it says last comments. I can't get to it. It says new comments. Okay. I'm clicking it, but it ain't doing nothing.
That's YouTube link, folks. That's all right. We'll get it out to everybody. I'll send it to Larry through Facebook. Andrea, I'll send you an email.
Okay.
All right. We'll get everybody over there. All right, folks. That's YouTube link, folks. Let's do it. Let's get over there. Thanks for watching. Andrea, I'll send
you an email. Okay. All righty.
All right. We'll get everybody over there.
All right. Bye.
Bye.
Let's get over there.
Thank you.